to be equal to minus 2ME over h bar. And this is true. So we have proved that tangent z can be written as z naught over z whole square minus 1 square root. So I can now plot the solution of the equation. So the solution of the equation is that I do plot, let's say this is for y-axis, and on this axis I am having z, and now I do plot the tangent of x. So we know that if, for example, this value is pi by 2, then tangent, I know the tangent is sine over cos. So for pi by 2, when this will become 1, this pi by 2 will become 0. So on pi by 2, the tangent become undefined. So let's say this is the pi by 2 line, and on this line we will have the tangent becoming undefined. Similarly, when sine phi is equal to 0, means when I go from pi by 2 another pi by 2, then this is another pi by 2, and I will have the plot of tangent here. So this is equal to pi. Similarly, I can take another pi difference here, and another pi difference will become 3 pi by 2, and this will be another pi by 2 difference. Let me go a little bit more here, and another pi by 2 difference will make this is 2 pi, and then we will have another pi by 2 difference, and it will be 5 pi by 2. So let's say this is our z axis. So we will have another pi by 2 difference here, and another pi by 2 difference here. So now we are going to plot from this 0, the tangent x, we are going to plot. Now I know at pi by 2 it is becoming undefined, so it will not be touching this line, but it will be somehow like this, and it will go to the negative side as well. I am only considering the positive side. Now whether we will have a plot here from pi by 2 to pi, let's check about tangent. So when sine pi by 2, it is greater than this one, and here from other values of pi by 2, so we will have only the negative portion here, and the negative I am not going to plot, but only the positive. So here I will not have any positive portion, and from pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2 I will have another same pattern, but like this. So there is no difference between this one and this one, it is just the repetition, because we are having two periodic functions, and tangent is periodic as well due to sine and cosine. So another repetition, here will be the negative portion which I am not going to plot, and another tangent plot will be here. So I have just plotted the tangent of z here. This is the tangent of z. So one side of the equation. Now the other side of the equation I can now check here, that This is 1 over z square minus 1. So 1 over z square and square, they are cancelling, and we will have a constant divided by z. So our z is a variable, and it will be a plot approximately like the plot of 1 over z approximately. So we will have to plot 1 over z. 1 over z is just like 1 over x, the exponentially decaying function. But exponential is very sharp, while 1 over x is not that sharp. And let me plot the 1 over z, and it will be something like this, for example. So it is a decaying function, and it is going like this. Now I see here that at this point, the two plots or the two equations are crossing each other, and these points are actually called the solution of the equation. So we are having from 0 to 5 pi by 2, we are having three even solutions of this equation. So our equation, we have solved this equation with the help of plotting, and now we these are actually the even solutions of our wave function, and the result is here. But so far we have not normalized our wave functions. Our wave functions are that the even wave functions psi of x is equal to g e to the power minus kx, and for x greater than a, and this is equal to d cos lx when x is between a and 0, and this is for minus x will be true as well, because our wave function is supposed to be even for x less than 0. And these are the even solutions, and now we will have to normalize. We will have to normalize these wave functions. So to normalize them, this is actually problem 2.30. Problem 2.30 is asking to normalize these wave functions, so we are going to do them. We know that the normalization condition is from minus infinity to plus infinity psi mod square dx should be equal to 1. Now here, these are our two wave functions. On this we will apply the symmetry conditions. So the two wave functions we are having is even, because if I replace x by minus x, the minus sign is not coming out. So we are having two even wave functions. And when a wave function is even, then we can write that this condition from 0 to infinity, only the one side, and psi mod square is equal to 1. So now we will have to put our wave functions here. So this wave function, it will be equal from when this one comes in, then this is for x greater than a. So we will have this one first, because it is from 0 to a. So I write that from 0 to a limits, the mod square of this, so 2 will come in from this and psi from here. So it will be d mod square, so I can write it as d because it's a positive constant, positive and real. And this will be cos square lx and dx. plus 2 will come again here, and then our integral will go from x greater than a. So it will start from a and it will go to infinity here, and the square of this, so g square e square, it will become minus 2kx. So here dx, we will have to note one thing, that we are writing here k while the book is writing not k, but it is writing is like this, which we call kappa. So we are writing it is k while the book is having the notation as kappa. Now we will have to solve these two integrals in order to find the normalization constant g and d. When we find the normalization constant, we will be able to normalize the wave function and we will be able to solve the problem. Now this integral is easy, but this integral we will have to do some calculations for this one. As I know that cos alpha plus beta is equal to cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. This is the general formula that I know. If I write that beta is equal to alpha, then this will become cos 2 alpha equals to cos square alpha minus sin square alpha. Now from the equation that sin square plus cos square is equal to 1, I can write that cos square alpha minus this, I can write 1 minus cos square alpha, and this will become cos square alpha plus cos square alpha, so 2 cos square alpha minus 1, and from here I can write that cos square alpha, when this one comes here we will have 1 plus cos 2 alpha, and then 2 will come down here. So for cos square lx I can write 1 plus cos 2 lx, so I will have 2 d square from 0 to a, and this will be half, so half for here, and we will have half here, then dx here plus 2 d square, again 2 d square, and then the next term, so 2 will come again, and from 0 to a, and cos of 2 lx, cos of 2 lx dx. Similarly, the next one I can write is 2 g square, and this will be integral from a to infinity, and e to the power minus 2kx dx, and this will be equal to 1. Now the integral is very easy to solve. Now I will not do further steps because it is not very difficult. This will become x, and from 0 to a it will become a, so it will become a by 2. Now cos 2lx dx, I will have to suppose 2lx equal to y, then 1 over y dy will be equal to this. I can write this one is directly as well, that this will be the sine 2lx by 2l. These will cancel, so we will have, and similarly this one will be e minus 2k, so 2k will come down as well, and we can simplify this. So we will have this integral equal to 2 d square and 1 over, this will become a over 2 plus sine 2LA divided by 4L and plus 2G squared and e to the power minus 2KA divided by 2K, and this will be equal to 1. Now we are having from this equation that G is equal, from here I can write that G is equal to, from here, from 1, the equation 1 that we have written earlier, that G is GE minus KA is equal to D cos LA. So this will imply that G is equal to D e to the power KA and cos LA. So I can replace G here, and the G value, it will be squared. So this is from equation 1 that we have already derived. When I put this value, then I will get that for that value. If I put, similarly, I do some simplification, that this 2 is canceling with this 2, and this will make this 2. Similarly, these 2 are canceling, so I will have d squared equal 2